Bingo. All right, nice trout. Yep. Oh, good trout.
Good morning and welcome to Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. I'm Kevin Ford. That's Captain Lloyd Landry. And we are doing some fall fishing. It's been a warm fall thus far, Lloyd, so we're actually going to start off today on the outside, move back in, maybe catch some speckled trout, maybe catch some redfish, but hopefully catch us some fish.
Yeah, seems like the fall bite is a month late, so we're still fishing all the outside islands and stuff, producing pretty nice fish, so can't complain.
We're going to see what happens out here today. Got a gorgeous morning, wind blowing out the north, temperatures in the mid-60s. We had a front come through a few days ago. Should be ideal conditions to catch fish today. And we're going to find out right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV. Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV is brought to you by Lakeshore Chrysler Dodge Jeep and Ram in Slidell. Best prices, service, selection, and yes, fish stories.
Boy, they're coming right
at
him.
Golly, you see their backs coming out the water. This is one of the most incredible sights you'll ever see. These fish are coming out the water. They're right here. There's about 1,000 of them.
That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it.
Oh, he's got one behind him. There he is. This is absolutely something that you see videos of. And you don't believe it, but look at them. You can look at them in the waves. There's just tons of them.
Oh, a shark! A shark ate him! That's the way to do it now. That's the way to do it. Hey, is this South Louisiana fishing or what?
Closed captioning is brought to you by Cypress Cove Marine and Lodge in Venice, Louisiana, where you'll experience world-class fishing. Visit us online at cypresscovevenice.com.
Oh, there one.
Got you one, run?
Got one.
Good job, Lloyd. I think the jig or the swim bait's the way to go right now.
Yeah. I mean, I honestly figured you'd get some better strikes on some bigger fish with those other baits, but when in Rome, do as the Romans.
Yeah.
Like, they're not big, but...
I had no idea you were Roman.
No, Roman Catholic.
Oh, okay. Close enough.
I'll put him in the morgue and say a prayer for him.
All right. There he is.
There we go.
Well... I've tried just about everything in the box. Now I'm fishing with a swim bait, which is a great bait to fish with in the fall, Lloyd. You know, we talk about this, and we did a show last year where we caught some fish on swim baits, and I love fishing with these because they're so easy. And a swim bait's real simple. It's just a ready-made bait. H&H makes them, Tsunami makes them. You tie it on, and you cast and retrieve.
Right, it's easy for customers. They don't have to jig a lot. You know, the bait's got a lot of action.
It's got a lot of action in the tail, and for some reason in the fall, you catch a lot of fish on them, so... Lloyd's fishing with a straight jig. I'm fishing with the swim bait. We'll see what does the best, but decent fish. No!
Booyah!
Lloyd's got one. Well, it's amazing to me though to see that we're sitting out here in what's normally a summertime spot. These fish are still up,
right.
And it's just been warm. So. Just because the calendar says these fish should be in cold weather spots, if the weather hasn't turned cold and it's been hot, those fish don't have calendars down there.
The other day when that front came through and we were catching them, it was really chilly to us. You know, it was 49, 50 degrees first thing in the morning. And all the fish we were grabbing, we were catching them, they were so warm. And the guys that we were fishing, they couldn't believe it. And the fish still warm. I said, dude, the temperature dropped yesterday.
Right.
You know, the water hasn't changed temperature yet. So, I mean, the fish are still... coming in from the outside, where they came from, I'm not exactly sure, because
right.
We hunted them down all summer. But we're still out here on the edge of the Black Bay, catching them. So
you know what the best thing about you catching that fish was?
What's that?
I can give you this one. And you can go put him in the back.
You're wrong.
Yeah, pretty much am.
I'm good. I'm a good guy.
I know you are.
It's the Super Clearance Event at Lakeshore Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
Do what I did. Join the winning team at Lakeshore Chrysler in Slidell for deals like this.
Ram Heavy Duty, $13,000 off. That's $13,000 off. Ram Big Horn, 27.27% off. Jeep Cherokee, $19,990. Patriot, only $14,990.
And we want your trade-in, paid for or not.
Save now at LakeshoreChrysler.com and Lakeshore Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Slidell.
Booyah Clean Non-Acid Instant Hull Cleaner is designed to clean the dirtiest of hulls, removing water lines, scum lines, fish blood, and stains in a single application. Just spray it on, let it react, and rinse with water. It's that easy, and Booyah Clean Instant Hull Cleaner can be used on all surfaces, even carpets and decals, and is an EPA Safer Choice direct-release cleaner with patent-pending chemistry. It's safe to use on water or land, and is endorsed by three of the legends in the fishing industry. Get yours at BooyahClean.com.
Plaquemines Parish, just south of New Orleans, is the premier fishing destination in the country. From bass fishing in the Mississippi River Delta to redfish and speckled trout fishing along the coast, to the best offshore fishery in North America, Plaquemines Parish has it all, along with waterfowl hunting and eco tours, several marinas, abundant lodging, great charter captains, and some of the best seafood in the world are reasons for you to come experience Plaquemines Parish, where it's not just fishing, it's catching. Visit us online at plaquemines.tourism.com.
With Farm Bureau Favorites, you're getting a great auto quote in 4 minutes or less, plus local agents and fast, friendly claims.
Great. Glad I went with Favorites.
No, it's Favorites.
Yeah. Farv.
Fave.
Farv.
Yeah, you know, fave. You know what? Doesn't matter. As long as you remember it's Farm Bureau.
Farv Bureau.
Yeah.
Get your 4 minute quote at Favorites.com today. Farm Bureau Insurance.
The best fishermen know that Venice, Louisiana is the place where you catch fish, and Lighthouse Lodge and Villas is located just minutes from Venice's marinas. Stay at Lighthouse Lodge and enjoy our brand new Bahamas-style rooms with all the comforts like satellite TV, Wi-Fi, refrigerators, and microwaves. Or stay in our condo-style villas and choose to have your own kitchen and room for the family. Either way, our staff is here to make your stay in Venice a great one. Escape to Sportsman's Paradise at Lighthouse Lodge and Villas. Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV is brought to you by Fins, right in the USA.
Boom, I missed him again.
You can't miss nothing, this is a guide strike.
Yeah, okay, watch this.
There you go, it's a better fish.
A little bit better.
Well, we're fishing on the outside, and we're not gonna get as many bites out here, but we're hoping we can find some bigger fish.
There you go, a double.
Hopefully we can find some nicer ones.
Yeah.
Because everything you're catching right now on the inside is what, probably 3-to-1 throwbacks?
Yeah, right now there's a lot of small fish.
Yeah.
But you know, fish, we just had our full, oh, there you go.
And what we're gonna get here though is
a little bit more quality fish.
Yeah, a little bit. And people are looking at these fish like, wow, that's a quality fish. Folks, it's fall.
Yeah.
I mean, it's fall fishing. We're a numbers place in the fall, and that's what you get. But a lot of places right now, there's just a ton of throwback fish. These
Which
are all
13, 14.
Yeah, these are all 13, 14 inches, and the chance to catch a big one. And that's
right.
Why we're out here right now, just trying to see if we can catch one. Maybe not. Probably won't happen. But at least we have a chance, more of a chance here than we have in some other spots.
Oh yeah, like I said, we've been catching a lot of small ones and a lot of numbers. Been catching limits, but you know, this has been. I've been having to sit there and measure 150, 200 fish to catch 75 keepers.
Right.
So a lot of action, but. You know, like you said, we came out here trying to catch a few better ones.
Yeah, and we could have gone on the west side of the river and chased birds today. Didn't want to do that, so we're going to fish some structure, move around, and my guess is we're going to find some nicer fish at some point today.
That's my plan. I like
that. That's what I think so.
But I'm not mad if we catch 50 of them like this.
No, I'm not either, especially since you're cleaning them.
Thanks.
There we go. Oh, nice one.
Yeah. You going to give me a chance to cast?
Not really.
Okay. I'll just unhook them and
yeah, you can get a chance to unhook them. I mean, you got to get... Whoa.
A little bit better one. That's what we were just talking about. He came off here at the boat, but that right there, this right here, that's just a solid little male trout. Real pretty.
Yep.
Old yellow mouth.
And you know, and the other thing is right now, we could probably be throwing corks and really waylaying them, but I kind of like when you can catch them, you know, casting and retrieving, bouncing off the bottom. I know you like to do that too.
Well, lately I've been actually fishing less with a cork, because it's been catching more keepers. with the cork, we catch a lot more throwbacks. I just kind of got to feel out customers if they get hung up a lot. You know, they want to stop and chit-chat and all, and they get hung up on the oysters. But you swim that bait, like you said, it's got a lot of action. And that fish right there, he attacked.
Yeah, he attacked it good, big time.
Oh, there you go, Cal.
Yeah. Good fish. Good one. Yeah, I'm getting some good ones now, Lloyd.
Yeah.
They're liking the swim baits. Look at that.
There you go.
Ooh, there we go.
That's two in a row, Cap.
Yeah.
Look, they came out the same mold, both of those fish. I mean,
they're hitting it aggressively, too.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, these aren't accidental strikes where you don't know if you have a bite or not. These things are just way, way in it.
What do you think he's thinking right now? He said, oh, my God.
He goes,
this isn't what I planned when I woke up this morning.
He goes, from the looks at the belly on this guy, I'm screwed.
Yep. You're fried. What was it? Oh, that's a good one. Nope. Nope. I tell you what, I thought he was bigger than that. That fish pummeled this bait. Good Lord.
Well.
Dude, this sucker just crushed it. You lost it?
Yeah, I lost it.
Well, that's
we're fishing structure here.
Yeah, that's one of the bad things. I lose so many jig heads here.
Yeah.
You know, but hey, look, you got to go where they live. And, you know, that's what I tell people all the time. You just got to keep swimming that bait over that structure. Keep your rod tip up and swim it over. And that's the result.
Nice fish.
Yeah, I'm telling you, they all out the cookie cutter.
Hey, before we hit our first fishing hole, our first stop is at a local Cracker Barrel convenience store. They have everything we need. Fuel, ice, drinks, snacks, and more, and even plenty of room at the pumps for your boat. With over 50 locations throughout Louisiana, there is sure to be a locally owned Cracker Barrel location near you. Cracker Barrel convenience stores. We have more than you expect.
Precision 2 Auto Care on South Sherwood in Baton Rouge is your one-stop automotive shop. From oil changes to major maintenance to new tires, our certified techs do it all. And we service diesels. Quality work at a fair price. Precision 2 Auto Care. Give us a chance to earn your business.
It's the Super Clearance Event at Lakeshore Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
Do what I did. Join the winning team at Lakeshore Chrysler and Slidell for deals like this.
Ram Heavy Duty, $13,000 off. That's $13,000 off. Ram Big Horn, 27.27% off. Jeep Cherokee, $19,990. Patriot, only $14,990.
And we want your trade-in, paid for or not.
Save now at LakeshoreChrysler.com and Lakeshore Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Slidell.
If you're buying, building, or renovating a home or looking to refinance, the local mortgage professionals at GMFS can help. Interest rates are still at historic lows. In fact, if you have an interest rate of 4% or higher, call GMFS to see how much we can save you on your mortgage. GMFS has over 250 team members all working to give you the best customer service possible. For your mortgage needs, call GMFS at 225-214-5040 or go to gmfslending.com.
Hi folks, Roland Martin here. You know, I fish for a living.
There's a bull red, 31 pound bull red.
Speckled sea trout, nice one too.
Oh my God, it's huge!
I got another one. Woo, woo! Bull red and kokanee, baby.
Come down here and do this for real.
Kokanee, just a few miles south of Houma, Louisiana. The limits are limitless. Hey, and the fishing possibilities are endless.
That's what kokanee, Louisiana is about.
MiraLure, the right tools to catch them.
There he is. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah.
Turn on the bite anytime. Tie on a MiraLure.
Beautiful. Bam.
Got him?
Right. Booyah.
Nice fish.
Yeah, another nice one.
Yeah, I mean, we started off catching the ones we started off catching earlier
were small.
You know, 13 inches or so. Now we're getting up to 15, 16 inch fish. Good job. And Lloyd, one thing, if Joey can show the water here in a second, put our baits in the water. We always talk about fishing clean water for fish.
Right.
But it doesn't necessarily have to be clean. If you look at our baits right now, there is no way we're fishing in any more than 5 or 6 inches of visibility.
Yeah. No, the water's pretty dingy.
This water is dingy. So.
Do you notice something though?
What?
Who's out here with us?
Nobody.
Right. So
The fish are still out in this water. Right. I mean, that's, we always talk about, oh, clean water and bait. You know what? Those are perfectly ideal situations, but if the water's muddy, you can still catch fish and you can still catch them on plastic. We're doing it today. I mean, that's about as dirty as you're gonna fish in out here.
Yeah,
and
well,
we're
mean,
catching fish.
The river's still high.
Right.
I say high, you know, it's over 5 foot, almost November.
Yeah.
So, you know, I don't think everybody was excited about getting that Green River fall fishing. It's not gonna happen. It's flooding in Missouri right now in Iowa. So, you know, you take the conditions we got. The nice thing is, we're out here by ourselves. Now it is midweek, but yeah.
It is midweek, and there's an island over there where guys caught 400 trout yesterday.
Right.
So, I mean, there's probably a
right.
good reason why.
Well, we saw them skint back running over there this morning.
Oh yeah, they were all running.
There's also been a lot of shrimp boats in this area. Boy, they've been really pounding the shrimp, and I mean, right now, I see 10 shrimp boats, you know, just glancing around. So it tells you this, if the shrimp boats are here, there's a lot of bait here. There you go.
There he is. Man, this is fun when you just, and these swim baits are as easy as it gets. You just cast and retrieve. There's no doing anything else. Well, that one there felt like he was bigger than what he was.
Yeah, that last one I caught, he hit with authority.
Fish are really feeding right now.
Yeah.
And these swim baits come in all colors. Basically, they come in all the colors that your normal jigs come in, and then they have the blue ones and all that that a lot of people use. But you were talking about catching them on purple and chartreuse when I talked to you on the phone, and I'm
right.
saying, well, if you're gonna catch them on purple and chartreuse, I'll try black and chartreuse.
Yeah.
And
something dark with a
sure
chartreuse
enough, it works.
Tail.
But I think right now in this dirty water, you better have that tail.
Yeah, that chartreuse tail is key.
Got him?
Yeah.
There you go. Well, we've made a move, and what you're gonna see is into some clean water. We've decided to go, it was a little bit rough on the outside, so we decided to make this move inside, and this is a bank that you've been fishing, Lloyd, for a while, and got some beautiful water, a lot of mullet in here.
Yep.
So
here's a cool thing. The water's so clear, you can see 2 feet better down. Yesterday, we were reeling in a fish, and they had 3, 4, 5 of them with him.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it was really cool. So, you know, I like to start way off the bank. You can see this mullet's all in here. And this bank is actually, you know, some banks are tapered. This bank is actually just a straight drop off, and the water's about 2.5 feet deep.
Wow.
It's about 3 feet deep out here. And you can see the mullet, and there's oysters, and there's little humps all throughout here. So we're just gonna drift across this. We catch another one, I'll put my pole down, and we'll see if we can catch a few.
What you got, brother? Nice
trout. I got a big bull red.
Oh, you got a bull red?
Yeah.
You know, I thought I saw one a second ago.
Well, they've been in here. They've been in here, and the ones that have been here have been giant.
Right, he's a little green still.
Oh, he's fixing to smoke out of here. He knows I'm fishing with my little
have
light
a nice
trout.
Day.
Thanks a lot, pal. I'm fishing with my light trout rod. But
I'll just maybe make a couple of casts here for.
We'll show the viewers what else they can catch besides speckled trout.
Can we get the net for you?
You keep fishing. I'm gonna get the net out right here. We'll get some pretty footage of him swimming around. You see how clean the water is. I'm not even gonna get the net. If he comes off, he comes off.
You want me to get the net?
I don't know. I'd like to, but.
Here, I'll get it. You told me you were gonna get it.
I know.
I'm kind of watching. I'm
acting like they do in Florida.
Yeah, I pick him off the belly.
No. I'm gonna get him in the gills.
That's how they do it in Florida, huh?
Yeah, that's. I'm becoming a conservationist, pal.
It's the summer clearance event at Lakeshore Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram.
Do what I did. Join the winning team at Lakeshore Chrysler and Slidell for deals like this.
Ram Heavy Duty, $13,000 off. That's $13,000 off. Ram Big Horn, 27.27% off. Jeep Cherokee, $19,990. Patriot, only $14,990.
And we want your trade-in, paid for or not.
Save now at LakeshoreChrysler.com and Lakeshore Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in Slidell.
Louisiana has the best saltwater fishing in the country, and there is no better way to enjoy the state's vast fishing opportunities than with a licensed, insured, and professional charter captain from the Louisiana Charter Boat Association. Whether targeting speckled trout and redfish in the marsh or monster tuna offshore, the LCBA has the right captain for you and your specific needs. And the best part is the state's liberal limits and year-round fishing. Go to lasaltwater.com to book your fishing adventure today. Just show up, get on the boat, and leave the rest to us. Get hooked with Louisiana Charter Fishing.
Out of the swamps of South Louisiana comes one of the finest fishing destinations in the world, Cypress Cove Marina and Lodge in Venice. Our lodge offers 61 newly remodeled rooms with free Wi-Fi and a ship store with all of the supplies you need for a day on the water. Cypress Cove Marina also features a dry stack storage facility, 8 fuel pumps, a 3-lane back down launch, and fish cleaning station. From bass to blue marlin, come to Cypress Cove in Venice, where your dreams become a reality.
This is Don Dubuque asking you to join me as a member of the Coastal Conservation Association. For 30 years, CCA has worked in Louisiana to conserve our incredible fisheries, making sure that our fishing is great today and for generations to come. Whether looking out for redfish and specks, eliminating gill nets, building reefs across the coast, or work at the state capitol and in D.C., CCA is doing what's best for the fish and the sport we love so much. Your $30 membership will ensure that this work and our great fishing endures well into the future. Go to ccalouisiana.com and join CCA today.
Nautic Star is making waves with their complete line of boats to fit your lifestyle. Our XTS series of bay boats leads the pack with extreme fishability, performance, and comfort. The Coastal and Legacy series are the perfect combo boats for fishing and fun. And the Nautic Star XS series of center console offshore boats blows the competition away with a smooth, dry ride. Visit our website at nauticstarboats.com to see videos of many of our models and to find a local dealer. At Nautic Star, we build a boat for you.
There we go.
Ooh, there you go.
That's nice a better trout right there.
There we go. Look, double.
We got a double.
All of a sudden.
All right, you go first. I'm coming behind you.
Mine's mine. I think you got me beat.
No, I don't know. I got a little. I lost mine.
But, Lloyd, we know we were talking a few minutes ago. We had about 4 or 5 bites, and then we go 10 minutes with no bites. So
right.
It's like you said, these fish are not stacked in here. They're just moving through here, obviously, because how do you go 10 minutes with nothing and then boom, 4 bites?
And I caught that bull red. So, right. You know, they're cruising through here, eating them too, you know?
Here, why don't you do that so we can eat him?
All right.
Since you lost yours.
Yes, punishment.
Oh, got a little pull. Boy, that was pulling nice. It's funny with these swim baits though, you don't know how big they are because of where they hook, but this looks seems like it's a 14, 15 inch fish.
There you go.
Oh,
look at that.
I could see he was barely hooked.
Right, well, you made a good swing. I'm gonna move that anchor. We don't need that anchor here.
But that's a, look, this is, I mean, these are.
Yeah, I've been catching solid fish in this cove. Like I told you, we haven't been catching tons of them,
but
they are pretty.
Look, what we've done today catching some bigger fish, and for fall, these are bigger fish.
Right.
To me, it's a lot more fun than going and sitting under birds and catching 200 of them to keep 70.
Yeah, nah, this is fun. And like I said, we picked through here, we caught a couple, you know, small trout, but pretty much everything we catch here should be this and a little bit bigger.
Yeah, we'll see if we can get a couple more. There we go.
Fish?
Yep, that was a fish.
I got off.
Too.
I got,
oh,
one.
I got mine. Oh, you got a nice one. Look at that. Ooh. Fish. Dang.
Yeah, a big one.
You got a big one, buddy. It's the same thing since we've been to this spot. You get a bite.
All right.
Yeah, I'm going to get mine in, and I don't want to show you mine.
Ah, he looked bigger than he was.
Yeah. Here, let me just.
No, don't kick him.
I want to get rid of the evidence.
I got you.
All right, that's a nice fish. Let me get from back here. All right. I'm just gonna throw this one away so nobody can see. I don't know if mine was bigger than yours or not, Lloyd.
Stop swallowing.
Boy, that's, he swallowed.
Yeah.
But you're right, these fish are, you can catch some nice ones out here.
Yeah, they're pretty. These are nicer fish.
Nice fish, buddy.
So, all
right. I'm gonna go get another one right back in that same spot.
10-4, I'm gonna put my pole down.
And we're trolling, we're moving, and then putting the pole down for a couple of minutes and seeing if we can get a couple more. It's just kind of stick and move. But a lot of people think in the fall, it's, you go to a place and you see all these reports, people catching fish all day long. I mean, you see ice chests full of fish and you think that these people are just sitting in the same spot. It's not the case. It's not, you have to move around. Like Lloyd said, he's been catching five or six fish off this bank every drift and then going back and making the drift again. So you may get lucky and sit on a spot and catch them all, but be prepared to do some moving and some sticking and moving, and by the end of the day, you'll have a nice box of fish. Oh, I missed mine.
I got mine.
You got yours? I'm gonna try to get mine. See if he comes. You got a good fish there, buddy.
He's not bad.
I love looking at him though in this pretty water.
Oh, it's, like I said, man, you'll be reeling one in and he'll have buddies with him.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. So, look, let's talk about a little bit how the pros do it. Let's talk about what you're doing. When you fish these banks this time of year, what's the key to catching fish? Because, like I said a minute ago, it's not every day you're going to come out here and stick the anchor pole down and just catch a limit. So what do you want to do as far as drifting these banks? How long do you stay in a spot? When do you start moving again?
Well, all right, as you noticed, we came in, I started 90, 80 yards off the bank, real far off. These islands used to be 3, 4, 5 times the size they are. And what most people don't realize is it's shallow all the way up to the bank. You mm-hmm. know, in people's mind, you want to rush and get right by the bank. Start way off, see how the bait's kind of positioning. You know, right now we have a falling tide. So the tide's coming, say, from the river, falling out towards Black Bay, out that way. And lately, the fish have been sitting for us on the windier bank. The windy bank has been better. So, you know, I just start way off that bank, and I'll stay about 2 cast lengths off of it. And all I've been doing is swimming just a 1/4 and 3/8 ounce jig head with a purple and chartreuse is what I've been throwing. But you know, a dark color bait, you see how clean the water is, and you gotta come in quiet because the water's clean and it's shallow.
Right.
You know, so we just, you ease into an area, I catch a fish. Normally I'll keep drifting a little bit. We catch one or two or miss a couple, I'll hurry up, I'll put the pole down, and then we'll just kind of fan cast. Because like you said, the fish aren't sitting in one spot. You know, they're just kind of cruising around back and forth. There's a lot of shrimp and mullet in the water right here. So, and fish are on the move. They're moving out from their summer pattern into the winter patterns, but they're not to the winter patterns yet. So we're kind of just catching waves of fish passing through here.
All right, well, that makes sense.
So.
Good job,
right,
bro.
Get you another one.
There we go.
There you go. Get you a big one, Cap.
I'm hoping.
Just average.
Nice fish.
Average fish.
But I'll tell you what, average or not average, we've had a great morning out here, man.
Yeah.
I mean, this has been super.
No, we got a box full. It was
got
a good
a box
morning.
Full of fish. Had a gorgeous morning to fish out here. You can't beat Plaquemines Parish in the fall. And that's how we're going to wrap up our day. Another speckled trout with Captain Lloyd Landry. Got a bull red, got a bunch of speckled trout, and it's still early in the morning. And Captain Lloyd, we appreciate it.
Thank you.
Look, great. We always talk about when's the best time to come fishing. Well, in Louisiana, Plaquemines Parish, all the time. But if you want to beat the heat, and if you don't want to get freezing cold, boy, October and November are really good months to come out here and fish. Not going to catch a wall hanger, but you're going to get plenty of meat.
Yep. A lot of good eating size speckled trout.
Hope you enjoyed the show today. For producer Joey Bordelon and Captain Lloyd Landry, I'm Kevin Ford. And we'll see you next time right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.